A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 2nd December, Monday. On the front page you have private telecom players hike rates, prepaid users to be hit. So private telecom players Bharti Airtel, Vodafone Idea and Reliance Jio have announced up to 40% increase in tariffs. So here you can see the old and the new tariffs shown. Up to 40% increase has been announced by all three. This has already been stated that they would be doing this from December onwards. The rates would be high. Telecom sector is in a mess. They have huge losses. And this is what has been done. So these three telecom giants actually account for 90% of India's mobile subscribers. And this is BCCI puts on hold changes to six key rules, refers them to Supreme Court. So this is regarding BCCI, Board of Control for Cricket in India. So it had its annual general meeting recently, but it has put on hold amendments to six key important rules of its new constitution. So this new constitution of BCCI has been approved by the Supreme Court and has been registered with the Tamil Nadu Register of Societies in Chennai in August 2018. But now as an afterthought, we have a BCCI new president sworn in recently, that is Saurav Ganguly. So now it has decided to refer six key rules to Supreme Court before being tabled before the annual general meet to be approved. So here you can see these amendments relate to powers of its office bearers and the apex council, the president, secretary's relaxation, in age, the age cap of 70 years for its representatives to ICC, then relief from obligation to approach Supreme Court to obtain its approval for every amendment it makes to the Constitution. So these are the rules are being referred to Supreme Court now. Then on page 6 you have solution to Naga issue likely soon, says CM. So Nagaland Chief Minister has greeted people on the occasion of 57th Statehood Day, contending that the long awaited solution to the vexed Naga political issue might be in sight. And he said people of the state are going to witness history now. So negotiations are taking place between Naga political groups and the center. So that's the term used for separatist groups. So here you can see. So says that there will be a solution to Naga issue announced soon. That is a deal as such which is being expected after the negotiations. And then here you have Guwahati University offered unapproved courses. So this is what the Comptroller and Auditor General of India says in its report, that Guwahati University has jeopardized the career prospects of nearly 74,000 students and collected 39 crore as enrollment fee from them by offering 21 unapproved courses through its distance learning centers for 7 years. On page 7 you have report on financial status to be placed before public, says the governor. So this is Maharashtra governor Mr. Bhagat Singh Koshyari, who has given his speech to the legislative body. And in this inaugural speech, what the Shiv Sena intends to do has clearly been seen. The coalition government, but these are Shiv Sena plans, the promise to have 80% quota for sons of the soil, 1 rupee clinic scheme, meals for 10 rupees. So these are part of the announcements in the governor's speech. And this is clear pendency of cases, improve training quality. RTI activists appeal to government. So these are RTI activists who say there needs to be transparency in appointments, display of queries, responses on websites. And also what has been stated, that there is a need for clearing the pendency of cases. So Chief Information Commissioner Shailesh Gandhi has also written a letter to the Chief Minister regarding the massive pendency of RTI cases and need to appoint more information officers to clear them. On page 9 you have Operation Clean Art to crack down on illegal trade in mongoose hair. So in a first pan-India operation, raids have been carried out in UP, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and Kerala. 49 arrests have been made and 27 cases registered. On these, you can see seizure of paintbrushes made of mongoose hair. So mongoose is listed in Schedule 2, Part 2 of the Wildlife Protection Act, and any smuggling or possession of its body part is a non-bailable offense. And here you have GST revenue crosses 1 lakh crore mark again. So average collections in 2019-20 now stand at 1 lakh 646 crores. And this is privatize 6 more airports. So this is what Airports Authority of India has recommended to the center, to privatize airports at Amritsar, Varanasi, Bhubaneswar, Indore, Raipur and Trichy. And this is revenue from Taj Mahal rising. So pollution is impacting the 17th century monument. Revenue here is rising. And the editorial page, the first editorial is Glimmer of Hope. So this is regarding the Fresh Sit report on 1984 riots. So this is special investigation team report on 1984 riots that may pave the way for reopening scuttled probes. So investigations into 1984 anti-Sikh riots, which took place after assassination of Indira Gandhi by her Sikh bodyguards. So that was also in retaliation to the Operation Blue Star in Amritsar, in which battle tanks were taken into the Golden Temple to shoot down the General Singh Bindrewale, who was brought down, who had, you know, rebelled as such and was a terrorist hold with arms in the Golden Temple. So this had angered the Sikhs because the sacred temple was made a battleground. And after that, her Sikh bodyguards assassinated Indira Gandhi, and post that we had the anti-Sikh riots, which were mainly targeting Sikhs in Delhi and all across the country too. So many of these anti-Sikh riot cases have been shut down, but now this fresh special investigation team report, it's the editorial says, may pave way for reopening scuttled probes. And this is Time to Act. So this is regarding how the economy needs a meaningful policy response with steps to spur consumption. The need for boosting the economy, boosting consumption as such in the economy will help boost growth too. Means people should spend. Then next is Macron's wake-up call to EU, European Union. So this is regarding French President Emmanuel Macron. He has rightly said that the European Union needs to assert sovereignty over its political and security decisions. So this is a background regarding EU too. Even NATO's diminishing role is highlighted here. You can see North Atlantic Treaty Organization, which is a military pact between US and European Union. Then this is making Air India's disinvestment work. So government has again brought up the plan for disinvesting Air India, and government needs to totally exit the carrier, but the acquirer should get full freedom to transform the embattled airline. But lack of strategic direction as such, as seen that there are no takers for Air India disinvestment. Then on the op-ed page you have the fountainhead of India's economic vitality. So this article says that Modi government has restored the social fabric of trust that had eroded in the UPA years. So this is Jayant Sinha, who is Lok Sabha MP from BJP. So he speaks about how India's economic vitality has been supported by BJP. Then this is battling antimicrobial resistance. So this article says that India must accelerate implementation of its national action plan on antimicrobial resistance, which is a serious cause of concern. So colistin is considered the last resort medicine to treat people with life-threatening infections. But then here also, the use of colistin in poultry industry has resulted in antimicrobial resistance against this last line drug too. So these are serious cause of concerns. On page 12 you have the curious case of 59 Bangladeshis who went missing. So government and police officials of Bengal claim to have no information on the group brought to Kolkata by Karnataka police. So now these Bangladeshis have gone missing. Their whereabouts are not known. Then on page 13 you have Islamabad's nefarious intent behind Kartarpur is exposed. So this is Punjab Chief Minister Amarinder Singh warning that Pakistan, warning Pakistan because its minister made provocative remarks recently. So here you can see what has been stated is the Kartarpur corridor, which was a brainchild of country's Army Chief General Kamar Javed Bajwa. So this statement coming from Pakistan's railway minister. So this has resulted in Amarinder Singh as such responding, saying that Pakistan's intent has been exposed. But this is known that the project was brainchild of Pakistan Army Chief himself. Then this is India-Sweden to sign MOU for Polar Science Cooperation. So India and Sweden are likely to sign their first maritime cooperation agreement too, and for cooperation in polar science. So Swedish royal couple will be on a visit to India. Then below you have, who is a farmer? Government has no clear definition. So such an ambiguity has serious implications for design and beneficiaries of schemes meant to help them. So government's definition of a farmer and how many farmers are there in India by that definition is here you can see. So it was agriculture minister who failed to answer this question in parliament last week. So government ambiguity has serious implications for design of beneficiaries. Like there is this flagship PN Kisan scheme, that is Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi. So who would be the beneficiaries if the definition of farmer is not clear? On international page you have, China introduces mandatory face scans for phone users. So news customers will have to record themselves, have a face scan done to get connection on their phones. So this will be mandatory in China. And then here you have, 6 European nations join Iran barter system. So this is INSTEX, which circumvents US sanctions. So 6 European nations have come together. So we have seen Iran has been seeing US sanctions after USA withdrew from the Iran nuclear deal. So now INSTEX comprising of, you can see these nations, which are Belgium, Denmark, Finland, Netherlands, Norway and Sweden. So this is France, Germany and UK, which are founding shareholders of INSTEX, which is instrument in support of trade exchange. So 6 European nations are joining these 3 nations now. So there will be 9 nations now under this barter system. So 2018, USA withdrew from the Iran nuclear deal, and post that it has imposed sanctions against Iran, and any entity which is having trade with Iran would be facing sanctions from USA. So to circumvent those sanctions, these are barter system which has been initiated with Iran. Then on Mondays on business page, you have this money wise coverage, which is not important. And then you have the last page covering sports news. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.